Okay, so today's agenda is what is Kafka. We'll just cover basics of Kafka, what exactly it is, terminologies of Kafka, and a brief about microprofile, not in deep, and how we can integrate Kafka with Thorntail. So what is Kafka? Kafka is a distributed stream processing system. It's a messaging based system where we can process the data from various systems, and it used on the messaging terminologies. What are the use cases of the Kafka? As you can see, there are multiple integrations or multiple interfaces for the Kafka, like consumer and producer, stream processor and connectors. What are the use cases of Kafka? As I mentioned, it's used as a messaging. Based on messaging, you can use it as a producer consumer, where most of the messaging things are used. Stream processor, everything in a Kafka is a stream. Even a stream of characters, stream of binary is considered as a stream. Event sourcing, you can track your website events in the Kafka. Website activities tracking and event processing quite similar. You can process the events also from the different subsystems, different systems in the Kafka. Log aggregation, you can use it as a storage for logs and commit log. Anyways, it's based on messaging, so it's just store the commit logs also. There are four core APIs of Kafka: producer, consumer, stream APIs, and connector APIs. Producer APIs are used to produce the messages to the Kafka, produce the data to the Kafka. The produced data is consumed by the consumer APIs. The stream APIs are usually used to process the streams from one subsystem and to put it into Kafka, or probably send it to another system for further processing. Connector APIs are basically used to connect the Kafka from a source where you can feed the data into it. Like for example, database, you can connect it and then feed the data into that. There are basic Apache Kafka terminologies, which are producer, as we mentioned, producer, consumer, but where they will produce and consume the data from. For that, we need a topic, where the topic will run on. We need a broker, a server, where you can run the topic. The other few, we are going to discuss it in details. The other few are the partitions, offset, and consumer group. As I mentioned that the Kafka is a distributed system. It needs to replicate the data across the distributed system. Therefore, we can use the partition. Offset is again a part of partition, and consumer group, you can create a group of consumer which can consume the data from the topic. We are going to discuss in detail again further. As I mentioned, this is a messaging based system. So every messaging based system needs three things. One is producer to produce the data. Another one is consumer to consume the data, and where to push the data and where from the read the data. We need a topic. The topics here are a bit different terminology from the basic messaging system. Usually there are queues and topics in the messaging system, but here as they are, there is a concept of multiple producer can produce it on a topic and can be consumed by multiple producers simultaneously. That's why they are considered as a topic. It's a bit different than the usual messaging terminologies. As you can see in the picture, the multiple producers, like two producers, are pushing the data into one topic, and consumer is consuming from that particular topic. What they are pushing in? Every message is considered as a record for a Kafka, and it is pushed into on the topic. Each record is having three main properties. One is key, with which it is pushed on topic. A value which we want to consume, or which we will be going to use, and a timestamp when it is pushing it on the topic. It comes with it's enumerable. You cannot change it after pushing it on the topic. It comes with a retention limit, where you can keep the record on the topic for a certain time. Otherwise, it could cause the high memory consumption over the system, and which will destabilize our systems. Every record is pushed with an ID. So you can consume that record with that particular ID. Where to push the record? On Kafka topic. As you can see, the topic, you can, multiple consumer can push the data on the topic. Each topic is having, each topic can have multiple subscribers. So you can consume the records from same topic. Now you can see here, there are three partitions mentioned, partition 1, 2, and 3 for a single topic. So what are the partitions? Partitions are, as you can see that, as you know that the Kafka is a distributed system, so we can distribute these partitions across the different nodes or different systems, where you can push the top messages on the topic by mentioning which partition you can, you want to push, so that you know that which consumer is going to consume from which partition. So every record, when you push in the topic, it pushed for a particular offset. Offset is nothing but the record ID on that particular partition. So as you can see it here, 0, 1, 2, 3, these are offsets on a particular partition. So if, when your consumer is consuming that particular data, you can say that I want to consume this particular data, this particular offset data from that particular partition ID or partition. This facility is provided by Kafka, and when you consume that record, it is not getting deleted from that there. It will still be existing on the partition. Who is consuming the record? Again, the Kafka consumer. When, as I mentioned, that you can ask the particular consumer that which record I want to consume. You can give the offset and you can consume that particular record. At the same time, if you have a group of consumer which can consume a particular type of data from topics, you can create a consumer group. And Kafka ensures that the single consumer will, within the consumer group, only record, only read that particular record once. The good part about Kafka, we missed one thing. We missed the offset. We also, I also mentioned that every record is stored as an offset into the Kafka topic. But how it is managed, how Kafka knows that I want to create these many replications, because as it is a fault-tolerant system also, how Kafka ensures that I need to have different partitions on different, how many replications of those partitions I want on different systems. Because if it also has a, it is a distributed system, so it also has, sorry, I forget the terminology, failover on init, property init. So we can mention the replication factor also about the partition when we are creating. So for example, if we are giving a replication factor of 2, so across the different nodes, it will be replicated twice. One is a primary, probably another one is secondary. So Kafka is a polyglot. Polyglot, I personally like this feature because I also worked on another technology, which is JDG, which is also a polyglot, which provide you a freedom to develop the client for any system in any language. Usually it work, it communicate over TCP, but we can use any language, any protocol like REST, HTTP, to communicate with that particular system, and we can use that as a consumer and producer. Now let's discuss a bit about microprofile. Why we are discussing microprofile? Because the Thorntail, which we are going to discuss further, is microprofile compatible. As you can see, the three dark patches below, these are the basic microprofile specifications when it was created. CDI, JSONB, and DexRS. The other J2A APIs were integrated later. We are going to use CDI to create our client for a Kafka with an extension. And how we are going to go, do that, we will see it further. Now, what is Thorntail? Thorntail earlier used as a Wi-Fi swarm. It is a microprofile compatible, as I mentioned. The framework is mainly based on the Wi-Fi application server, and we can create a standalone micro microservice-based application out of this. It creates a Uber jar as well as a Hollow jar. You can use it for running it on Docker, and with the help of that, we can create a microservice. It doesn't need any application server to deploy it. The microservice, and we can directly use it as Java minus jar and the jar name. Arrow Gear has an integrated is providing a CDI extension for Kafka, which helps us in developing this code. It removes most of the code which we have to do it, and gives us annotation, which helps us in creating the client for that particular for creating the client for Kafka. As CDI, it's push the dependency into the variables, and we can use that variable accordingly. If we don't use this particular CDI extension, you can see we need to write this many lines of code, and we have to continuously poll that particular topic to read the record and then do the processing of that particular record. But if we use the CDI injection, we can just use the annotation Kafka config, where we can just specify the server and the port for that particular Kafka broker, and we just need to we write a normal API on any messaging system. On message, we just need to mention that what is the consumer, which topic it is going to read, and what would be the consumer group it is in. So we can see a small demo how we can do that. So right now, what I'm doing in demo, I am first starting a zookeeper. So what is a zookeeper? Zookeeper, it helps Kafka in managing the distributed system over which the Kafka server runs. I just hold it. So when I start this zookeeper server dot start, it start the zookeeper at 2118 over the local, and which we need to provide. Later on. So now we are starting the Kafka server, which is a broker. The Kafka server is created. It started. Now, we are going to create, we are going to check the topics which are created over the Kafka zookeeper, and check what topics are right now exist. So if we see right now, there is only one fruit topic, one topic, and nothing else, and one consumer offset. Now I'm going to create a topic called fruit topic, and It is created over the same zookeeper. Now when I list it, it is created. Now I already built two jars for consumer and for producer for this Kafka. I just run it. If you can see all the CDI extensions and everything is inbuilt due to the microprofiles. The Thorntail is ready, which means the jar is started and our web service is started. Now I am starting the web service for producer. Which is running on 8180 and it is running on 8080. So these are my interfaces where I am pushing the data on this. I am pushing the data into the queue or onto the topic, and behind the scene the consumer is consuming the data and pushing the data into a database. After that, we will refresh and fetch the data from that particular database. We push one fruit. You can see it is consumed on the same queue. If you see the logs, it is consumed with ID 1, so I am pushing that particular ID from the producer, which is auto-generated on the offset, and it is consuming that particular data from based on that ID. This is what I pushed. This is what I fetched. Similarly, I push another. It is pushed. It is consumed. The two, as I am pushing it into the database, the two fruits are consumed. So you can see I'm using this Kafka extension. These are the dependencies which are already added from the Thorntail, and I'm giving this as a CDI extension. Similar pom.xml is here. This is the when it is fetched. It is selecting that query from the database to show it. This is our get API for the web service. And here I am pushing the data on the fruit topic with an ID and the object which consists of the name of the fruit. So here if you see, here if you see, I mentioned that this is the local host 9092 is the broker where the Kafka is running, and this is the producer. I just need to mention it, what is the key and what is the object it consists, it needs to read. So I'm just, this is again a consumer, where I'm, so I'm just mentioning it, consumer to topic, the key type, which is like ID, which is an integer, and the group ID, which is a which we are providing. I think that's it from the demo side because we are shooting time. So anybody has any questions? If we are in, yeah.
I saw you have the consumer and you have the packet in the key.
For that particular topic or for particular that partition, and then can I fetch that particular data? So I'm not certain about that. Probably we can because I haven't tried that. But probably we can. I'm not certain about it. I need to try. I can get back to you on that if you can just share your mail ID. Yeah, sure. Anyone else? Nothing. And these are the references which I followed for this. Thank you.